up on everybody's energy. Let's see what's going on. So, what is the current energy for my collective? Oh, very nice. Okay, I see you reaching out to your friends with the Four of Wands. I see you getting insight, introspection, trying to understand something about your situation here. With the Ten of Swords, I see you kind of feeling defeated, feeling like something had to come to an end, a cycle has to break, just kind of being like over something here. Right, just kind of being like, what the fuck do I do? Right, and that's why you're going to your friends. You're like, what the fuck do I do? With the Magician in reverse, I feel like you have, like, discovered the truth about, like, somebody trying to manipulate you or deceive you in some way. Somebody who is very secretive, right? Magicians never tell their secrets. And the left hand never knows what the right hand is doing. So it's like they could just be very fucking sly, very fucking convincing, you know? So let's see. Four of Wands. What are you getting introspection for? Ten of Cups. 10-10, endings and new beginnings. You're looking for a way to get your happy ending. You're looking for a way to feel fulfilled. Or like, you know, you're looking for your Ten of Cups. Ten of Swords, something ends here. You know, feeling very defeated, feeling like, I mean, this bitch has 10 swords coming at her, you know, like, feeling fucking impaled by whatever happened. Betrayed. Yeah, Ace of Wands, you get a passionate new beginning here. As a result of whatever that ending is. With the Magician in reverse, discovering that somebody is, like, just full of shit all the time. Let's talk about that. If somebody was just trying to create, like, an illusion or a separate reality for you to perceive. Four of Swords in reverse. I feel like you had intuition. Like, you felt like a lot of strife, you know, especially with that Ten of Swords. You felt a lot of strife, a lot of shit that, you know, you couldn't relax. Eight of Materials, I just see that you, like, ended up focusing on your work or, like, your talent. Or, like, some sort of hobby here. You just kind of focused on something that kind of kept you distracted from feelings, you know? You're like, well, if I'm enjoying myself, I can't feel feelings. That's what I do. but, yeah. Anyway, so, let's see. What else? Devil brings conflict into your mind and into your heart, right? They're the muse of conflict, right? They're the muse of confusion. They inspire confusion. They inspire doubt. They inspire conflict within yourself, right? And that's why that's showing up with the devil, right? And with the magician in reverse, that's, you know, I feel like you're dealing with somebody here who really corrupted your perception on a situation. Somebody who is very narcissistic and only out for personal gain. They seem quite friendly when they need something, don't they? Why is this devil here? Ten of Wands in reverse, because that's who you're breaking a cycle with. It's like you guys did this thing over and over and over and over, same shit, expecting different results, but then it was always the same and you were kind of over that. Now we have 10, 10, 10. 10 to the power of 3. Endings and new beginnings to the power of 3. You might have 3 endings, 3 beginnings in regards to different aspects of your life. There could be friendships lost, there could be a job change, there could be moving into a new house, there could be some sort of transition to the power of 3 here. Yeah, 6 of Pentacles. I see this energy of like restoring the balance of give and take in your interpersonal relationships. 8 of Wands, I see this energy of like co-creating and also being very driven and motivated towards something, right? Really creating your reality. I also see so many cycle cards here, right? Look at those. It's like past cycles, needing to overcome past cycles. I feel like that's a big part of it. Yeah, and with 8 to the power of 2, because you have 8 of materials and 8 of inspiration, that's like mastering. Like 8 is the number of mastery, right? So you're mastering unity. You're mastering cooperation in your life. You're mastering taking charge of your life, you know, and really being solid and being able to work together as well. I see that with the 6 of materials that like, there is like a restoration of balance between the give and take. And the flowers didn't really start showing up in the reading until later, right? Like, and I feel like that really represents like spring and blooming. You know, you had cactus, you had desert before that, and it's kind of like desolation. And it's like, and now you're feeling more fruitful and like, like more things in life are possible for you. And it all showed up with some petals that were lost here. This guy fell. Yeah, Page of Materials. I see an offer being made here. I don't know if it's from you or to you. But I noticed that hella driven energy moving towards a direct path here with the Page of Materials is kind of like, somebody wants to bring in a message somewhere, right? And there's more flowers showing up in this. And I don't know, I'm really seeing all these flowers. It's really fucking symbolic here to like springtime or love. Especially with the coloring of the flowers, it's all pink. Pink is all love, you know, if you're into like colored candle magic, like, you know, using colors in your magic practices, you understand pink is love. Pink is the aura color of love. Like I fucking said, bro. Queen of Cups, dude. Queen of Emotions. I see hella fucking love showing up in here. And I don't know if it's even romantic love. It's just this blossoming, this blooming love. It's like being very emotionally mature and really, you know, feeling a lot of fucking love, man. It's just, it's almost overwhelming it so much. You know, I see it a lot in these flowers. It's like almost overwhelming. That's how deep it like runs for you. Four of Emotions in reverse, Four of Cups in reverse tells me that somebody wants to make an offer, which goes back to the Page of Materials. Somebody wants to make an offer, but they don't want to be rejected. Two of Swords in reverse tells me that they're, like, not at peace with, not having it. Three of Materials. This could be, like, a coworker or roommate or whatever, but Three of Pentacles is typically a connection made through some sort of, financial thing, you know, like money is intertwined in your connection somehow, so it could be somebody you've worked with or lived with. Ace of Materials, Ace of Pentacles, I see an offer coming in here, I see a breakthrough happening here, a new beginning, and I just keep seeing more fucking flowers, I'm telling you, they're just... And it's like, there's other cards in the deck, and they're just not so flowery, you know? Like, a lot of them are not that fucking flowery, you know? Like, shit, dude. It's just like, later in this reading, all these flowers just start showing up, man. Like, it's just growing. It's that energy of growth. I feel like... so much growth, so much expansion, so much coming through. It's like, it's opening up my heart chakra just looking at it. Like, it's a lot. I think you might get scared of your feelings sometimes because of how much it is. Yeah, Knight of Cups in reverse, it's like being scared to say anything. But at the same time, with the Queen of Swords in reverse, not wanting to cut off anybody there. Muse of Swords, it's like you have this internal conflict in your mind about it. Like, you're like, what do I do? You know? And with the Empress showing up, you know, that's like saying, like, stand in your power. And just kind of, like, let your heart guide you, if you will. Like, let yourself be guided by the divine. Just stop worrying so much about the outcomes. Transcend your past cycles. The cycles that didn't serve your highest good or whatever. And just kind of flow with life, you know? You don't have to be so worried about the outcomes. You don't have to overthink everything. You could literally just exist and let life kind of fall into place for you. All this anxiety and worry about it ain't gonna change what inevitably happens in your life, right? So just live in that knowing. Three of Swords tells me you're heartbroken. because you don't want conflict. You don't want to come forward because you feel like it's going to be like a negative experience. Why do you feel that way? Why are you like preparing for imminent doom already? Like it hasn't even happened. Like, why would you be so worried? Page of Emotions in reverse. You don't want somebody to hate you. The world, cosmos, you care about what others think of you, how they see you. The Nine of Wands in reverse, you've come a long way in your life. Nine of Materials, you feel like you've gained a lot in your life. Why would it fuck so hard with your reputation? We have the Awakening, the Eight of Voices in reverse, and the Four of Materials. I feel like you hold on to a certain image of yourself, but I feel like you're also taking off the blindfold and understanding that about yourself. And I feel like you're coming to an awakening here where you're starting to realize what's actually important and what, you know, what's actually important to you. The Moon card with the Page of Wands in reverse tells me that you learned something about somebody lying here, right? Like you learned that somebody lied to you about something. With the Queen of Materials, this causes you to like really hold on closer to something, right? What did you discover? I just want to know. What did you learn? On this, sorry, like that's an incomplete sentence. let's see. Interesting. So, Seven of Materials, you were focusing on things that you didn't have, right? You're focusing on the things that you wanted to obtain, right? Seven of Swords in reverse. I feel this energy of you kind of letting your guard down, which I'm going to clarify about what. But with the Two of Materials in reverse, it tells me that you're still kind of in that mindset of like, oh, I had no choice. Whatever that means. The Chariot in reverse tells me that you had no choice. You couldn't move forward, right? With the Knight of Swords in reverse, it tells me you didn't want conflict, like we said in the past. Like, it's just kind of coming back to that. So, Seven of Swords in reverse. Queen of Wands. It's like, with somebody who comes in and speaks their truth to you, and just kind of lives their truth, you kind of, you lay down your swords with them, and you're just kind of like unguarded about their energy at this time. You just feel like maybe, I don't know, it's like the way this person spoke their truth to you, it helped you like kind of feel safer in their presence, I guess. The Two of Pentacles in reverse, feeling like you had no choice, you couldn't move forward with the Chariot in reverse. The Hierophant, you needed time to learn, time to grow, time to really get that divine guidance on a situation, right? Because you didn't want the conflict with the Knight of Swords in reverse. Yeah, the Hanged Man in reverse, or the Hanged Muse in reverse. It's kind of like, because of the way that you handled it, it's like obstacles will fall away for you naturally without you needing to lift a finger or have any kind of conflict. It's like having that trust in the divine to really bring about the life you want without you having to, you know, like beat yourself up over any decisions. You know, the divine's got your situation handled. Like, just don't overthink your outcomes, just kind of go with the flow. Every day is your outcome. Five of Materials, I feel this energy of you feel kind of left out in the cold emotionally. Like, you feel like there's just something that, it's just always out of reach for you, right? The way this hand is here and that person's just like lying there suffering. It's like, it's so out of reach. Like, feeling like I said, going back to that energy of feeling like you have no choice. It's just out of reach. The Priestess in reverse. Is happening. The Muse of Materials. I see somebody very divinely guided, right, on their path here. With the Knight of Wands in reverse, it's like unable to bring in a message or unable to say something. The Priestess in reverse, feeling like, I don't know why, but in this, the way that this is reversed and in the context of the rest of the cards, I kind of get this feeling of like, feeling like you lost the energy of this Priestess rather than, I don't know, because I feel like on the flip side, there could be somebody here who is, you know, kind of not divinely guided. Let's clarify it. Let's see what this means. Yeah, like, I feel like this reversal is in regards to something that you couldn't have, right? With the Three of Wands in reverse, it tells me that it could have been a love triangle and you didn't want to step on any toes, and that's why you didn't want any conflict, and that's why it fell out of reach for you. Five of Cups in reverse, it's like you don't feel like your love was wasted on this person. You love them. It's just you don't know what to do with it, right? And with the Lovers in reverse, it's like you feel like they're out of reach, right? With the Priestess in reverse, I feel like that's just saying that you had a priestess who you feel like is unattainable, right? You can't reach it, so it can't be in the upright for you. It can't be, you know. With the Death card in reverse, though, it tells me that energetically, you're not letting go of this situation. Even with all that you feel about it, you still don't want to let go of this connection, because you don't feel like your love is wasted on them. You just feel like you don't want conflict. You don't want to be trapped in the middle of a love triangle. You just want something that's stable and easy, and, well, not easy, but like something that's just solid without all that complication, really, right? Muse of Inspiration, Muse of Wands, that really tells me that, like, this person inspires you. They pull out the magic in you, you know? You feel, like, powerful in their presence. Three of Cups in reverse. You don't want to lose your friend. I feel like that's part of this, like, Three of Wands in reverse, that third party energy. You don't want to lose your friend. Yeah, Five of Wands in reverse, you don't want conflict with them. That's understandable. Strength card. You have the strength to overcome anything. You're gonna be fine. You're gonna do fine. You're very protected. And whatever you choose, I feel like you'll always choose the right thing for yourself, right? Like, even if you feel like you've had to cut a loss here or whatever, I see it this way. That which God puts together can never be put asunder. So, it can never be taken apart. If it's meant for you, if God gave that to you, it's always yours, you know? And you don't need to overcomplicate your life for that. Right, whatever is a God-given gift, you never have to overcomplicate your life for that. I don't give a fuck who you are, right? You never, ever, ever need to compromise your honor for anybody or anything. Yeah, Knight of Materials in reverse. You never need to make that offer. Because that which God puts together can never be put asunder, right? If it's meant for you, it'll be yours. Bottom line. And any obstacles will fall away if it is meant for you, right? Like, we've got the Hanged Man in reverse. Obstacles will fall away for you if it's meant for you. Yeah, the Fool in reverse. You don't need to take any impulsive actions. You don't need to tear down the tower, right? I feel like you've been through a tower. You're rebuilding, and you don't need to do anything that's going to set you off course, you know? I feel like you're already restructuring your life, you know, from whatever emotional towers you've experienced in the past. And I feel like this is just a really important journey for you to really understand that, like, having faith in the divine to take care of you is a very strong position to be in, you know? You will have all that is meant for you. All you have to do is ask, bro. Like, have you ever asked the divine for what is yours? Just be like, could I just have what you intend for me? You don't have to say a specific name or anything like that. I think it's worse if you do that, because then you're, infringing on somebody's will, and I would never, ever, 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 ever recommend doing that. It's been done to me. I would never condone it. But if you ask the universe for what is divinely yours, or to reveal to you your divine counterpart, that's a whole different thing. Then you're just kind of like making a spiritual, setting a spiritual intention to know your spiritual journey, like what is meant for you on your journey, you know? Nine of Swords in reverse. Feel this energy of like letting your swords down, right? Not being defeated, not having to have any conflict, like kind of just relaxing, right? Two of Cups in reverse. It's like kind of accepting the situation for what it is right now. And then what's your future energy as a result? Six of Swords, you'll take divine guidance, and the divine will lead you through any obstacle. You see, the divine is carrying this man across this, so he is not harmed, right? So, wait, that's not a man, that's a woman. Whatever, it's carrying this woman across the river, keeping her safe from harm, and it's like, feel like you'll be able to believe in the impossible with what the divine will do for you if you simply ask for what is meant for you, you know? Yeah, Two of Wands in reverse, it's saying don't be at a crossroads for anything, right? Yeah, something feels unfair right now. Also, you have 222, right? Two is all about unity. It's all about cooperation, right? The Justice card in reverse, something feels unfair to you, right? The Star card in reverse, something feels hopeless. Like, you're like, I don't know how this could ever be possible. More of those ruminating thoughts, right? Eight of Emotions is saying you need to walk away, right? And from what is this Page of Swords in reverse? And I feel like it's saying you need to walk away from all that doubt. You need to walk away from all that hater inside of you that, like, tells you that things are not possible or whatever. I think if you have a dream or an aspiration or whatever, you can absolutely aspire for that, you know? If it's something set in your fucking soul, aspire. Let me go get that card. Yeah, dude. The Ten of Materials, Ten of Pentacles shows up. You end up getting everything. You have a bountiful harvest because you planted the right seeds. You did it the right way. Right? It's like you just need to chill and stop worrying so damn much about the outcome. Your outcome is going to be fine. I'm going to drop some oracles on here for you. You silly banana. You're going to be okay. commemoration. Commemorate your milestones, man. Understand, you know, like, you deserve a little honor for all that you've done for yourself, right? How you've managed it, right? When your heart was broken with the Queen of Hearts, you're a rare bloom and you handled yourself very well. Says mistakes teach us. So learn from your past mistakes. Learn from where you've gone wrong on your path before, right? With the farewell, it's like, I feel like this is saying farewell to your past self. Farewell to your past cycles. Farewell to anything that doesn't serve you, right? Daisy and the dandelion. I see this energy, right? Like I said with the two, like that unity, cooperation. And I feel this energy of like, making a connection, a really deep and meaningful one, you know? And that's all because of all the sacrifices that you've made. You know, you leave yourself open to your prosperity, your abundance, your Ten of Pentacles, you know? But that's what I have for you. Namaste. I love you all. I'll catch you later.